has made unilateral statements inconsistent with policy positions collectively adopted by the government and contradicted the president on critical matters of governance and the exercise of the president's function as a symbol of national unity. Three, gross violation of Articles 6(2), 10(2A), 174, 186(1), 189(1), and the fourth schedule to the Constitution by undermining devolution. That His Excellency the Deputy President interfered with the running of Nairobi City County Government by inciting citizens against lawful directives of the county government on the planning and relocation of markets and publicly disparaging the leadership of the county government and its decisions. Four, gross violation of Article 161 of the Constitution on the institutional and decisional independence of judges. That His Excellency the Deputy President has undermined the institutional and decisional independence of a judge through public attacks on a judge of the High Court of Kenya and falsely threatening to file a petition for the removal of the judge of the said judge in a matter in which he was a party. Five, gross violation of Article 31 and Article 148(5)(a) of the Constitution on the fidelity to the oath of office and allegiance. That His Excellency the Deputy President breached his oath of office and allegiance on account of the utterances and actions attributed to the Deputy President under grounds 1, 2, and 3. Six, serious reasons to believe that His Excellency the Deputy President has committed crimes under sections 13(1)(a) and 62 of the National Cohesion and Integration Act. That His Excellency the Deputy President has persistently made inflammatory, reckless, insightful public utterances over the last 2 years in contravention of the law. Seven, serious reasons to believe that His Excellency the Deputy President has committed gross economic crimes under sections 45(1), 46,